Hi everybody, myself M. Manjunath Reddy, proprietor of Sai CAD, Kengeri, Bangalore, India. I welcome you all to today's topic, that is tetrapod. How to create a 2D tetrapod and also how to convert that into a 3D model. Let us see. Now, here in this screen, what you are seeing here is the tetrapod images here. You can see that. Now, beside this, if I zoom into this, you can see the 2D drawings here. The dimensions drawings are assumed here. The circle radius is, you can see very clearly, 1500 mm, 1.5 meters that is. And here if I come, the diagram of the 2D model, you can see that including the slopes, taper cut there, the 170 mm, here is 100 mm, this is a 220 mm. Length is 1500 and here the width is 480 mm. Now why I'm showing all this is to convert ultimately like this picture here, what I mean to say, this one, this segment here, and finally to convert back to this. Now from this I can generate a 3D model. Now how to do this also I will tell you in the 2D model, then we'll go back to 3D here. Now beside this, I take up this, let me take have one reference line from this center of, I'm going to say line command, L-I-N-E, line command. From this center, okay, I've taken from the center with the ortho on, straight away I'll come here, done. Enter, done. Now let us draw this step by step. I'm teaching you step by step method, how to create a 2D model first, then we will see 3D. Now circle diameter is 1500. Let me say, C enter, circle, C enter, at this point, this end point selected, directly I'll say 1500, enter, done. Radius is set for 1500, done. Next is one vertical line here to here. Obviously, yes, that will be 1500, one vertical line from here to here, straight away to that particular quadrant. Selected, enter, finish. That is also over. The next is 480 mm towards right. And top in the stop 170, 170 480. Done. I'll go here, I'll go back to line. This is 480 and the top side is 170. From this endpoint, I'm taking here 170, enter, done. Finish. This drawing is over now. Now I wanted to offset that 170 horizontal line. I wanted to offset to 100 mm first. Then that should be 220. That should be 220. 100 mm offset and 220. So now I'll go back to offset, O enter. You all know that O enter stands for offset command. Value is 100, 100 enter. I zoom into this line. I select this line, put it down. Done. It has been placed. But the both length is 170, 170. But as per my drawing, that's supposed to be 220. Now, how do I increase the line length 170 to 220? Yes, the command is lengthen, L-E-N-G-T-H-E-N. This is the AutoCAD command, lengthen, enter. I go to directly total. In the total, I click here total. I say 220, it's already there default, 220, enter. I said, just click on this line, that this edge, I hope you can see my cursor there. If I place at this edge, automatically line will grow to the length what I have mentioned. Enter. That, so I mentioned 220 mm, the line grow to that particular dimension. Now I hope you got clear picture of the outline. So I said straight away take line from here, from this edge. To make you very comfortable, I switch off ortho so that you can see the line where the generates from here to here and finally to end up this here. That's all over. Drawing is finished. 2D diagram is over. Now, I will take out this segment, this drawing, this 2D drawing, I will take out, copy, click and place outside with the ortho on mode. Done, finish, over. Next is this, to convert this into 3D model, I no need to have this line now. This line is just a reference. This I took it as a reference line. I will delete this now. I'll delete, done. Now outline is ready now. I'll go back to one more copy. Let me have one more copy here. Duplicate, CP enter, done. Fine. Again, I'll zoom in now. Now, please note, this is just a 2D. Separate line, separate line, separate line, all are separate. So how to convert back to single unit is, I go back to region command. R-E-G-I-O-N, region command is to convert 2D drawing into one set or one entity. I select complete drawing, enter. So please make sure in your system also, after selecting complete unit, that should reply on the command prompt here in the bottom side, one loop extracted, one region created. Then that is a confirmation. This drawing is now eligible for 3D model. Now, again, let me have one more copy. Let me have one more copy here to here. That's all over, finish. Now what I'll do, now here only I wanted to convert this. I will show in 2D only, we'll convert this into 3D model. Please note that I go to P enter, pan. P enter is pan symbol. Now please watch out, we are in a top view. Right now we are in a top view. I hope you can see my top left cursor movement there, and we are in 2D platform. 2D, all the icon buttons, menus are related to 2D only, but still I can convert this into a 3D model directly in this 2D platform. How is that is, I'll go to revolve command. R-E-V-O-L-V-E, revolve command, enter. I say revolve command, enter. I select this drawing, enter. Then I pick the axis here. Which axis I need to revolve this symmetrical drawing here is, I just click here, this as well, this endpoint, X endpoint done. Done directly. Then you can say, what is the revolution angle? You can see here in the bottom side, specify angle of revolution. I say directly 360 degree, 360, enter. Done. That 2D piece, the 2D drawing now converted to 3D model directly. Now, how to see the 3D model is, hold shift button on your keyboard. Press and hold shift button on your keyboard, plus press your mouse wheel and hold and drag like this. I hope you can see now, I'm orbiting. This is the concept is called O-R-B-I-T, orbit. I'm just rotating in a 3D. This is not actually rotating, this is shuffling, looking around 360 degree the model. But still, you may have confusion in this wireframe looking into this kind. But let me show you clearly in 3D view. I will go back to 3D now. How to change 3D platform is here in the bottom side. You can see my cursor tip, workspace switching here in the bottom side. In this, I'm switching over to 3D modeling now. Not the basics, advanced topic, just 3D modeling. So once I click on that, you can notice on top of the, all the ribbons, menus, toolbars will shuffle towards 3D model. Now we are all the toolbar, the layout is set for 3D. In this, directly I go to visualize. In this here, I hope you can see visualize. In this, I'll go to 2D wireframe here. Here it is. In 2D wireframe, I click there and I wish to choose shaded with edges. Here, this one, shaded with edges. If I click on that, your model will be shaded directly the color. And now it's a better, you see the 3D model. I select this and now again, I go to orbit. You all know orbit means press and hold shift on your keyboard, press the mouse wheel and drag. There's a one segment of 3D model we generated. Okay, now what I'll do, I will go back to 2D again now. How to go back to 2D now? Directly in visualize here, I go to top view. 2D means the top view, the default top view. I'm here now. Now what I'll do next is, I go to slightly move up this. Done. I've taken slightly moved up, no dimension. I've not mentioned any dimension. This should be a bit away from the top side here. Now, why I have taken a bit away here is I want to watch this from the right side now. Right side here means I want to show you the model, this 3D model by standing here. We will stand up here now and look towards this. Means we are coming to right side now. So here I'll take you to right side view directly in this here. I repeat, in the visualize, right side. Yes, this is a perfect view of the right side of the model, right side of the 3D model. P enter stands for panning. I go here, I zoom in here, exit. Okay, I slightly increase my command prompt number of rows here, number of columns, rows. Okay. Now here I want to rotate this now to certain angle. Now what I'll do now, let me have one more copy of this. I will choose to select CP enter. I click and drag this outside one more piece. Done. Okay. Now, as per my design, this has to rotate and tilt now. So here what I'll do, I use a 2D command only. Please note that right now we are in right side view. This is not a plan view or this is not a top view. This is a right side view. You can see my cursor here. Top left. We have selected right side view. Done. Here again, I'm going to apply 2D command, that is rotate. R-O-T-A-T, rotate command, enter. I select this model, enter. And I wish to choose here the center point here, center of O-snap, snapping to center. So directly I say C-E-N. Now on the command prompt, I am typing C-E-N, enter. And here I choose here, this center. I hope you can see this point here, here my cursor point. Yeah, I selected. Now I say minus 25 degrees, enter. Tilted. Got it? Now similar way, this one, this piece, this three model, I repeat the same command, rotate, enter, select this complete model, enter, again same thing, C-E-N, enter, center of this point, I say 90, enter. So this is the vertical PC, vertical model, this is an angular model. Now why I have taken that is, now I'll explain you in few seconds. One is a vertical piece, one is a minus 25 degree, we are tilted by using a normal rotate command, which we use in a 2D model, right? Now, I wish to go back to 3D model. How to get into 3D model now? Now, directly you can go back to Southwest also, or same as usual, I told, shift and hold on the keyboard, press mouse wheel and drag this. This is the beautiful 3D model, what we are looking at now. Now, I want this to be three numbers as per my tetrapod drawing model. We need three numbers of this and one vertical member. Now, what I'll do here is now how to get three is simple method is an array command. Array. Now, I'll go back to, I'll ring to reshuffle to set back the UCS coordinate system. UCS double enter. So that will come back to original home station, also world coordination system, WCS. World coordination system, XY is on a base plane. Now I'll go to apply 3D array, A-R-R-A-Y. 3D array, the one word, no space, 3D A-R-R-A-Y is the command. Now that's asking for select object. I'll select this, enter. That's asking for type of array. I go to choose polar, P, enter. Polar, selected, enter the number of items. I need three numbers, done. Enter 360 degree, yes, accepted, enter. Next, rotate arrayed objects, yes, Y, enter, accepted. Specify center point of array, again I say C-E-N, center point of this here. I hope you can see my cursor tip here on the model, yes, selected. And make sure that ortho is on, please note on. Now system on the command prompt, it's asking for specify second point of axis. I go straight with this ortho is on. So now we are moving in a Z direction. Length is not important. This length is not important. Either shorter or length, very length, whatever you can make it up here. I click just directly here. That's all over, model over. You got this? Again, I go back to shift and drag the mouse by holding the mouse wheel. You can see that three pieces, it's a particular equally distributed, no, within that 360 degrees, it's come. But please note, these are all separate actually. But because of the array, this acts as a single individual entity, but these are all separate, separate, separate. Now what I'll do is, I want to move this also to center of this now. So what I'll do, this piece, this 3D model, I want to move and place to center of this now. Now what I'll do, again, let me have a copy of this all. To show you that very better example, let me have a copy, let me have a duplicate this. Beside this, let me have one more. Done. I use just a normal copy command. This is done, over. Next is, finally, I'm going to normal move command, M-O-V-E, move command, enter, select this model, enter center of, enter this center piece, this center. I'm choosing this one, this center here, selected. I'm just moving with the ortho off to show you very effectively how to locate this event to the center of this. Again, CEN, enter to this center here. Done. It's located perfect. Located all around, clear now. But when I zoom into this closely, the edges are not crystal clear. The edges are, the model, 3D model edges are not crystal clear. So what I'll do to make that clear, again, I'll duplicate this. Let me have one more duplication here to here. The next is, now what I'm going to do is now I'm applying one more command that's called as union, U-N-I-O-N, union command, so that I can weld, W-E-L-D, that's weld all the four pieces together. One, two, three, four pieces as a one single unit. So I'll select all together by crossing window selection. Click anywhere, anywhere you click, drag to left side. The green patch has to come with the dash lines. Select complete model, enter. Now you can see the difference between the edges. I hope you can see my cursor point here. Here, my cursor point, the edges are very, very clear all around. The same thing you can see, the left side model is not clear because it's not at unioned. U-N-I-1, union is not applied to this. I have applied to this. So this got a single piece now. This is single unit now. This has got a separate. So I hope you understood this clear explanation on my example. I'm going to orbit again. This is a top view of the tetrapod. You can see that. Let me say in the top view directly here. I go back to top here directly. This is the model which you have done. This is the image. This is the image, real image from the site that you can see that here, the real model we have done in a AutoCAD. First, we did a 2D as well the 3D. Now I'll go back to here and I choose Southwest, SW Southwest view. Now, if I focus this, yeah, you can see the crystal clear edge now, right? So today's topic completed. I hope you enjoyed the session and gained good skill. Have a nice day.